Let us then confess our sins to God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have been sins in our lives. We have sinned against you and God's will and peace by helping us to find our lives and our friends. We have not been able to help. We have not helped our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may be right in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for your sake, forgive you all your sins. And to call and ordain servants of Christ and by his authority, I pray that you work forgiving all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, true God,
Son of the Father from eternity.
Lord Jesus Christ, true man,
Lord of the Virgin Mary.
The great cost you saved and redeemed us, lost and condemned creatures. Not with gold or silver,
but with your holy and precious blood, and your innocent suffering and death.
Claim us as your own, to live under you in your kingdom.
To serve you in everlasting righteousness, innocence, and blessedness.
In your precious name we pray.
Who with the Father and the Spirit and the one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. If you go to Broadway, you see unique productions. The craftiness of Broadway musical author creates a playlist of songs enabling the hearer to move through a story and have it spiced up by the meaningful articulation of solos, duets, and chorus pieces. Today, as we celebrate that Jesus is about undertaking his mission as Savior, we're going to attempt to do the same thing with the story that's coming. I will share a little conversation about God's promises, a word from God will be shared by Pastor Otto, and then you will sing a song to connect to the story. Anyway, the scriptures are like these. Thousands of years of history, thousands of years of God's activity in the world He created, and it's all compressed into one little book. God decided to put the greatest hits in one place, so that whenever we want, we can connect with the major stories of these greats. We can listen to the songs. Of course, the heart, core, and center of the musical is the Savior who was promised from the day Adam and Eve fell into sin, and moved gradually toward His role as Messiah throughout the Old Testament. To Abraham, He was the descendant who would bless all people. To David, He was the coming King who would reign forever on the royal throne. To Isaiah, He was the light that would shine in the darkness and bring peace and joy to those who were destined for destruction. Michael declares the place of His birth, and His deep shepherding love. And then the promises take shape. The clock is ticked down and the time has come. The Christ is born. God becomes a man. The music takes on a different sound. No longer are God's people waiting for the one who would rescue them. He came and He won forever by His death on the cross, victory over sin, death, and the devil. And the songs continue to play as we celebrate. The old Simeon just days after the birth of our Savior, the Magi who rejoiced with the gifts of gold, incense, and myrrh. St. Paul, the church of his day and ours, and in the end to all peoples, gathered together before the throne of God in heaven. So enjoy the musical, and hear God's marvelous salvation through the ages in His life. The first promise of the Messiah is made to an unlikely character. To the serpent, these words were spoken, who wreaked havoc on God's creation. God declared that He will raise up one who will crush the serpent's head. This child of promise will be God, but will be fatally bruised by the striking from Satan's enemies. Yet in the end, when He rises from the ashes of death, He will emerge as King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
O the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and all wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, you will eat dust all the days of your life, and I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. You will crush your head, and you will strike his heel.
Join me in singing one verse, the first verse of the Hebrew reading. Stars of the sky and the sand and the seashore. And one of those stars would be the star who would bless the whole earth. The star of the Messiah would shine brightly with hope and joy so that God's people would know forgiveness of sins and life everlasting. We join in singing of the Word of God from Genesis chapter 15.
The Lord said to Abram, look up at the sky and count the stars, and indeed you can count them. And he said to him, so shall your offspring be. I will make you into a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
He brought that star to Abraham, and the star of the life to us. Let's join the singing. The second song, Jesus be one, together.
Thank you.
The latter days of the kingdom of Israel were also dark days, filled with warfare, idolatry, and eventually being deported into a foreign land as a defeated and broken people. But God didn't give up on the ones he loved. No, he lifted up the promise through the prophet Isaiah that hope could be found in a child who would be born. A child who would be the Son of God. He would save his people from the darkness and their life.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. And those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
We join in singing our fourth song, Low Power Road, but some verse 1.
Thank you.
After years and years and years of waiting, he saw the angels bring out. First, to Mary.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The angel said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words, but the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High."
He is here to accomplish a mission, to win our salvation. needless to live.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Perhaps even up to a year or more after Jesus was presented at the temple, Led by from the east are guided by a star. Familiar with the message of Messiah from the time when the prophet Daniel lived in Babylon, they had come to worship him who was prophesied as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In Matthew chapter 2.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked him, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place the child was. They saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, and of incense, and of myrrh.
And I'm going to sing verses 1 and 2 of
Thank you.
O giver of all good gifts, you gave the greatest gift, your own beloved Son. You offered him as a sacrifice of atonement so that we might be saved, so that we might have new life, so that we might have hope and joy. We bring these gifts before you today, that that word might be proclaimed among us, and that it might be proclaimed throughout the world, that others too may hear and enjoy the good news of salvation that comes to them and to us through our Savior Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen. We pray, Lord. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. For this congregation, its mission, and its people. For the ability to meet the needs that arise as we do the work God has given us to do. And for the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have wandered from the faith, that the Holy Spirit would use us to call them home to the Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who suffer from hunger, homelessness, poverty, or unemployment, that God's great mercy and love would preserve and relieve them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, we take the time today for those to remember those who are sick, that you would grant healing to their bodies and strength to bear their infirmities with patience and grace. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who mourn, that in this their time of sorrow they would not lose hope, but rely on God's promise that he will never leave or forsake them. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who rejoice in the rich blessings of God, that they may always remember the giver of every gift and offer him heartfelt thanks. Let us pray to the Lord. O Heavenly Father, who opened up the heavens and sent your own beloved Son, we thank you. Deliver us and preserve us. To you alone we give all glory, honor, and worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
St. Paul declares to us that the song of Christ's birth is not just a song, it is our song. For Jesus came as a servant to die for you and me, to pay the price for our sins, to win our salvation. He is our King of Kings. He is our Lord of Lords. He is our Savior from death and hell. And his song will ring out forever and ever. For he is the Lamb of God, King of kings and Lord of lords. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise.
Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature of God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself nothing. Taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
and suffered to us his very body and blood. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the same man who is the pure and good bread, and so he can thank you, go to the end of his disciples, and take it to take my body, which is for you. This is good remembrance of him. In the same way, all of you took the cup after supper, and when he can thank you, give it to him, saying, drink it always. This cup is the redemption of my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it. Remembrance in the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
And that you can follow the charity of the Lord.
Thank you. Christ may strengthen and preserve you steadfast in the true faith, the life everlasting.
We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this gift. We thank you that you sent your own beloved Son into the flesh to offer himself for us. Use us as your people to serve him faithfully and to spread the good news of the gospel to all who will hear. In Jesus' name we pray, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
back to the altar for the celebration of Christ's birth. We thank you for having us here today. We've been burning on the altar, which is good, and make sure that all things are put to be in the land. And also, Barbara, for everything you guys are working with, I have reason to be confident that anyone has done without the will of the anger. But we certainly rejoice in the confident of Christ's birth. Thank you all, and the Lord, you do this for wonderful work.